Isang pagpalang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Good evening, everyone. This is Brother Jonas, and this is for our Lockdown to Look Up series, your daily inspiration amid the COVID-19, day 220. 220 days of being together. And I'm just so excited because tonight we'll be learning a lot of things. And I know that you will be blessed. Beautiful, beautiful discussion tonight. I promise that you will be blessed. So sit back and relax because I know that God will actually do something tonight in your life. I'm just so excited. You know, every night in the past 220 days, this is part of what I do. And I'm just so amazed that we were able to survive in the past 220 days studying the Word of God, encountering God, of course, learning powerful principles that we can use in our everyday life. And another thing that we are learning here is we are also adapting powerful habits that we can use every single day. And I'm just so excited because I'll be introducing beautiful, beautiful topic for tonight. And it's something that you really need to hear, okay? Please listen carefully for you to know our message for tonight. So just for a while, I'll just share this video so that many people, please do try to send the link to your friends so that they will be able to know and to learn something tonight, okay? So while I'm sharing this, I hope that you're all doing great. I hope that you find happiness with what you do. And I hope that you are doing so much great. Yeah, I'm just so excited. Yes. You know what? Every night before I start, I actually ask God to give me the wisdom so that I can share with you the message. And of course, I ask God that the message will remain in your heart. We want to magnify God tonight. We just want to honor God tonight. And I'm just so excited. Okay. So tonight, let's start the ball rolling. Okay, I'll just turn it off. Okay, perfect. Okay, so our topic for tonight is this. Mm-hmm. Our topic is about blessings can become curses. Sometimes, you know. Yes, Kate, how are you, Kate? Thank you so much for being here. Sometimes, or most of the time, blessings can become curses. Now, I don't want you to react. I want you to listen first because I will justify my topic tonight. How come, Brother Jonas, my blessings will become curse? Yes, because sometimes if your blessing is too heavy, if it's too heavy, it can crush you. If you are not prepared, it can crush you. Okay, so what I want to share, a good example is, for example, a lotto winner. The lotto winner receive at least maybe 100 million. But after 3 years, after 4 years, that 50 million, 100 million will go into the thin air. And it will just disappear. Sometimes it even causes quarrel, conflict, and sometimes it also causes a lot of problem to that person. Now, that became a curse. Money is blessing. Winning in the lottery is blessing, but it became a curse. Now, for example, okay, I know someone, I have a friend who became very rich, yeah, financially stable. But during that time when he was earning more, he was actually, his money, he used it for immorality. He used it for his vices. Now, that's a blessing. Okay? He was blessed with financial prosperity. But the problem is, he is not prepared. He doesn't know how to manage it well. It's like nothing fails like success. That's our topic for tonight. Be very careful because I want to share with you foundation that you need to develop, okay, in order for you to enjoy the blessing and to truly receive the blessing. Most of the time, we receive the blessing, but we squander our money, you know, we mess up because we are not ready. There's problem deep within us, our core, there's problem. And so tonight, when you will listen and put into your hearts the message for tonight, you will know how to take care of your blessings because we also need to take care of our blessings, okay? Example, my illustration. Example, this is my blessing, okay? I'm actually holding my blessing. What if God gave me a lot? Okay, and it became heavy. Instead of me enjoying the blessing, it can crush me. Okay, it can cripple me. It can wound me. And now it happened. Okay, because what's the reason behind the blessings becoming a curse? Because the person is not ready. The person has a very shallow foundation. Now, receiving God's blessing, you need to have something, okay? Receiving God's blessing, you need to develop a lot of foundation, okay? So I will introduce tonight our big message. Yeah, it's very easy. I already introduced our big message for tonight is if you can carry your blessings, it can crush you. Now, you need to become strong. You need to develop your character. You need to become tenacious because if you are not ready to receive that blessing, it can crush you. For example, promotion. Yeah, promotion is a blessing. But sometimes because people are not ready, people sometimes it gets into their heads, the blessing become a curse. Right? And sometimes overseas Filipino worker, there are some who work overseas. When they arrive there, they earn a lot of money and they left their families here. So it's supposed to be they receive a blessing because they are earning much overseas. But sometimes some OFWs, they fell into immoralities, of course. And sometimes it can cause broken families. It happened already. The blessings became curse. Okay, and for example, for example, financial prosperity, like for example, God gave you more money, but because now you have more money, you can buy expensive food or sometimes you can buy something for your vices. There were times before wherein I felt like God is not giving me more because God knows that I will use it. I will use the money in a not so good things now. I will be very honest, but I want to dwell what is specific, but it's not good, okay? And I felt before that, maybe God is not really giving me much money because I don't know how to manage. When I was able to handle 50,000, I squandered it, I messed up, and then I tried to learn, and then God gave me the 100,000 to manage and the 500,000 until such time that I can already manage higher amount. So that's it, okay? If you don't know how to manage your blessings, if you don't know how to carry your blessings, it can crush you, it can wound you, it can cripple you. The blessing became a curse. And our Bible verse for tonight, but before we present our Bible verse for tonight, let's pray our favorite prayer here. Are you ready? Let's pray. I want you to feel the prayer. I want you to feel the words. I want you to live it, okay? Like it's part of who you are. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today, I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today, I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today, I proclaim that I am God's beloved, I am God's servant, I am God's powerful champion, and because I am blessed, I am blessing the world in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you so much watching now. Eileen Aguirre is here. Larry is here. Thank you. Ate Maricel, thank you. Doc Marilyn is also watching. And Cindy, Gail, I miss you already. How are you? Okay. So our Bible verse for tonight is from the book of James, chapter 4, verse 10. And it says, okay, humble yourselves before the Lord and He will exalt you. Humble yourselves. Now, I'm an avid fan of humility. And sometimes this is one of the first questions that I ask myself whenever I'm having my soul-searching activity. I actually take some time, off at least every 2 months or 3 months. I ask for a 3 days break. And during that time that I'm in my quiet contemplation, I often ask myself, Jonas, are you still humble? Because people, that's one thing that people admire you before. Okay, people always remind me, we admire you because you are humble, like you embrace humility. And then sometimes I felt like I already became what I post in Facebook or when I speak with other people, like I felt in my heart that I'm becoming bad. So during my reflection, my soul searching activity, I always ask myself, Jonas, are you still humble? Because you need to become humble. You need to humble yourselves down. You need to seek God. You need to become kind to your friends. You need to speak nice. And sometimes because you know, success will come, and we forget this, we forget humility. So the Bible verse is telling us, humble yourselves before the Lord and he will exalt you. God will celebrate the humble. God will actually lift the humble. God will actually bless the humble, because I believe that humility will aid in receiving your blessings. So whenever God sees that you are embracing humility, the blessings will flow more freely. The floodgates of heaven will be given, will be opened, and it will come to you, okay, thoroughly, because of humility. And God loves the humble. God loves the humble. What God is doing actually to those who are humble, God will lift them up. Okay? So that's our Bible verse for tonight. Humble yourselves before the Lord and he will exalt you. Okay. There are five things that I want to cover tonight. Now, in order for you not to convert, transform that blessing, your blessings into a curse, there are five things that you need to do. Very important. And I think that all these things should be preached. A lot of people, especially those who are living in a life of success, especially those who have more money, especially those who have more fame, especially those who acquire material possession. I met a lot of people. And one thing that I observe, especially one thing that I observe is always about humility. It's always about character. Now, I met people who are very intelligent, but they lack the character. I also met people who are not so, okay, average, but they lack character. There's no specific, you know, but everyone, every person, poor or rich, most of them, or with a higher organizational position or simple employee, I observe sometimes. But here's what I observe. The higher, okay, the people are they're in the organizational posting, or the richer, most of them, they forget humility. They forget their character. So number one here, main foundation in order for you not to convert that blessings into a curse so that your blessings will remain blessings, number one that you need to do is to develop the first foundation. The first foundation is all about your character, your integrity, and humility. Now, you know, you can sleep sound at night if you protect your integrity. Like, you know deep within your heart that your conscience are clear. As for me, telling other people negative things, like, for example, I became angry. When I sleep at night, I'm actually sad, but and I regret why I was able to blurt those words. You know, I was able to speak negative words or not so good words. Words alone, it makes me sad. But there are people who murder. There are people who kill other people. There are people who fight physically. There are people who abuse other people. I don't know whether what happened with their character, what happened with their integrity, what happened with their values. Now, if you are humble, if you are kind, your character, since young, you don't know how to steal money. Like, you never, okay? You never experience stealing other people's money. Now, that's one thing that really my parents taught me when I was young. And that's one thing, that's one value that I always remember. And I'm really proud because they taught me, especially my mother, taught me that even a single peso, I don't have any right to get that if that's not mine. And she instilled that belief in my mind, you know, that principle in my mind that I will never, ever steal money. And character, integrity, Zig Ziglar said that with integrity, you don't need to wait for your price, because the price of integrity is integrity itself. You are, like, your conscience are clear. You can sleep sound at night. You don't know that you're not stepping on other people's lives. You know that you are kind. You know that you are not doing bad things to other people. When you walk somewhere, when you visit a place, it's all right. You can walk straight because you know that you did not pull other people down. You did not talk negative things about other people. Like, your conscience, it's really clear. That's why you need to protect that. Okay, let's check the opposite. Now, if you did not protect your character, integrity, and humility, for example, since when you were young, you know how to steal money. Okay, you're a chronic liar. And then one day, okay, you will be given the chance to be promoted in your company. And you cannot just forget that. It's part of who you are. Instead, that God bless you with your promotion, it will turn out negatively. Why? Because your blessing became cursed because of your character. Because three things, this character, integrity, and humility, when you forget these three things, I'm 100% sure that you will never, ever become successful. Yes. You know, your money, your fame, by a snap of a finger, God can remove that. God can teach you a lesson. It happened to a lot of people. They when they are having a lot of money, they think that they own the world. They think that, oh my gosh, this is real success. They forget God. They forget a lot of things. They forget their character. They speak negative things about other people. They did not protect their integrity. They stole money. Okay, they became corrupt. And then they forget to become humble. By snap of a finger, God can give you something, or the enemy, I don't know. But I remember a story where in very rich man, but became too proud of what he is doing. And then God gave him cancer. I don't know if God gave the cancer, but sometimes God allowed that to happen, in order for us to embrace humility. And little did he know that because of that experience, he humbled himself down and he went back to God. That's the story. Okay, happy ending, at least. But sometimes can do everything to remove anything in your life because you don't own anything. Because even your life, you don't own it and you don't have any right to boast. Everything you have now is because of God's grace. Yes, your breath, your life, your house, your car, your career, God's grace. You're just a trophy of God's grace. Okay, so that's number one. Character, integrity, and humility. If you don't have these three things, your blessings can curse, your blessings can crush you, and your blessings can be converted. Instead of being a blessing, it will become a curse. Okay? Amazing. Number two. Okay. Another thing that you should never forget is this. Another foundation so that your blessings will remain blessings are your relationships. Yes. Yes. I met people who, when they became richer, when they achieve a lot of, when they had a lot of achievements, a lot of accolades, they become famous, they forget other people. And they forget their, where they came from, the people who helped them before, they forget all these people. And now, when you do that, I really believe that negative energy will always bounce back to you. So whenever you forget those people, you set aside these people, you no longer want to help them, that's negative energy and it will bounce back to you. Never ever forget your family. I see people who are becoming more rich, who are receiving a lot of accolades, but they forget their family. They forget their friends. They forget their parents. They forget their siblings. They forget their best friends and close friends because their achievements, because their material possession did not enter here, but it entered here. Okay? They became too much proud. And again, I want to remind you one day, okay, if you will not behave, if you will not connect with your family members, by a snap of a finger, it can disappear. Yeah, by a snap of a finger, it can disappear. So please, while you are working, never ever set aside your family, especially children, especially the youth. Never ever forget your parents, especially your parents who work hard for you. It's your time to give back to them. I still see people who are so proud, okay? Example, they fight with their parents and the children, they don't have any like initiative to connect with their parents, initiative to fix it with their parents, okay? If it's all about abuse, if your parents will never cooperate, then it's okay. But at least try to reach out. Because if you did not fix your relationship one day, that blessings, okay? It will your relationship will affect your blessings. And then one day your blessings will become curse, will transform from blessings. Instead that you are blessed, you'll become, you. Instead of living a blessed life, you will live a curse-filled life. Never ever forget your relationship. I believe that one form of wealth is our relationship. One form of wealth is our relationship. Relationship with our parents, with our siblings, and with our friends. Okay, that's number two. Number three. Okay, how about this one? Okay. In order for your blessings not to become a curse, number three. Yung sobrang init, pwede mag-electric fan ako. Air continuous muna tayo. Okay. I hope na hindi mahagip. Nagpapuwisan ako. Okay. Mali yung numbering ko. Number three is all about never ever stop learning. Don't stop learning. Okay. Yeah. Number three is all about personal development. Now, if you'll become successful, you need no need for you or something will happen to you if you stop learning. Now, you always hear it from me. Nothing fails like success. Because many people, when they receive so many things in their lives. When they achieve their goals, they stop stretching, they stop growing. They think that that's it. Okay, they become complacent, conceited. And again, one of my favorite quotes I heard from our dean before in our College of Nursing, she said, "There is no room for conceit and complacency because you are only good in your last performance. There is no room for being complacent, for being conceited, because for being conceited because you are only good in your last performance." So whenever you achieve something, example, you were promoted. If you are promoted, the more that you don't stop learning. Read books, attend workshops, find mentors, connect with people. Because when you stop growing, when you stop learning, of course you stop innovating. And the very reasons why you achieve success in life will become, if you forget the very reason, then that's the start of your downfall. Yes, you were promoted because you attend training, because you improve yourself, because you study, you attend a lot of workshops and training and seminars and read books. And when you stop doing that, and you are promoted, that blessing can sometimes become a curse. Okay, so that's number three, never stop learning. Apart from the grace of God, what I have now, who I am today, is because I embrace personal development, continuous learning. Yeah, I still read books every day. I attend workshops. I still attend in my public speaking workshop. I still attend in some workshop related to entrepreneurship or anything that I know I can get something. Okay, so that's one value that I learned in order for me to keep my blessing, in order for my blessing not to become a curse, okay, not to become cursed. So please, please never, ever stop learning. Number four for tonight, okay? Another thing that I want to share to all of you is this, okay? This is very important. Now, money is important. I will never discount that money is important. All of us, I work hard to earn more money. You work hard to earn a salary. I think it's implied that almost all of us, we want to have more. We want to have more. But I want you to use money as a motivation. Okay. I want you to use money wherein this quote, the ultimate purpose of wealth is to love others. You use your money to bless other people. I want you to use your money to become a blessing. I want you to use your money so that you can magnify your message, so that you can help a lot. Now, money and awards and achievements and material possession are just secondary. Your top priority here is the number five. But just make it secondary. If you strive to have more money, never ever sacrifice your character. Never ever sacrifice your integrity. Never ever change your humility. Okay? Never ever stop learning or growing. Most of the time, when we see that, oh my gosh, I have this big house, I have my car, and I'm living my life to the fullest, sometimes we forget the essentials. Always remember this. Money, it's just one form of wealth. Just one form of wealth. Relationship, form of wealth. Character, form of wealth. Your health, it's one form of wealth as well. So money is not everything. Money is not everything. But money is important, okay? I'll never discount that. But I want you to have this perspective that you want to earn more money. I want you to use it to bless other people. I want you to use it to inspire other people. Use your money to bless other people. That's our purpose here. But never, never make money as your number one priority, because there are other essentials. If everything is just all about money, then all the people who are richer should be happy, right? If happiness or contentment will come from money, then the rich should become happy. But there are rich who commit suicide. There are rich who are empty. Why? Because it's not just about money. It's not just about mansion. It's not just about sports car or four-wheel car or the latest car. It's not just about the latest gadgets. There's something there, okay? There's something there that they forget, the essentials. So the foundation here is, I want you, in order for you not to convert, in order for you to protect your blessings so that it will not become a curse, I want you to think that, okay, money is secondary. Okay, these are my five priorities. Other things here, money will just come here, okay? Money is just here. But my priority, number one priority, is the number five. Your number five is this, okay? the most important thing, the biggest, the best foundation that you need to develop, okay, the most important foundation that you need to nurture is this. Number five, it's all about spiritual relationship. Yes, that's what I believe. Your blessings will stay blessings if you have this relationship, spiritual relationship. Now, what is a spiritual relationship? Okay, the most important thing is your relationship with God. Prayer time, connect with God. Not only during your prayer time as well, but every second of the day, you know that you are connected with God. Like talking to God, even just one phrase, one sentence. Okay, Lord God, I will start this. Please help me. Lord God, I will do my life already. Please bless me. Lord God, I will write my book now. Please bless me. Lord God, I'm going to school. Please bless me. Like, it's part of who you are. It's like lifestyle, a lifestyle of prayer. Okay? So that's it. Very crucial. Another thing with regard to a spiritual relationship is we need to read the Bible. Every night you are reading the Bible, okay? Every night we are reading the Bible because we are presenting one Bible verse here. And our Bible verse is James 4:10, humble yourselves before the Lord and he will exalt you. So that's one thing that we can meditate upon, right? You can meditate with the word of God every day, and that's connecting with him, and that's building our spiritual foundation. You're the only one who know your spiritual foundation, your spiritual maturity, your spiritual relationship. I cannot tell that. You know, okay? You cannot lie to yourself. You know whether you are really connected with God. You know whether you have that deep relationship with God. You know whether God is your priority. You can never lie to yourself. And you know that. So if you think that, you know what, Brother Jonas, I think I lack this number five. Okay, I lack this number five. I don't have my relationship with the Lord. And sometimes I even forget him. And sometimes I feel like he's very far from me. Now, think about it. Whenever you receive your blessings, instead of that blessings, okay, will stay as blessings. It can become a curse because you don't have God in your life. I had a friend wherein we converse. Like, she is already a matured friend. She had a lot. She has vast of, you know, experience. Like, she is... One time she became rich and then she went bankrupt and then she went back and all these things. And I asked her, what could be the possible reason when you were very rich and then what's the main reason of your downfall? And then she shared with me, you know, that time my main priority is money. My main priority was appreciation. My main priority was fame. My main priority is all about my travel, you know, my vacation. Everything is just about money. Money, car, mansion, everything. That's her focus. She doesn't have God in her life. She doesn't go to church. She doesn't pray. And God removed everything in her life. And you know what? That moment, that experience in her life actually brought her, directed her to search for her real happiness and contentment. And she shared with me, you know what, Brother Jonas? The real contentment in life is all about having God in your life. Now she prays every day. Now she reads the Bible every day. And then, but, okay, here's the good news. Here's the good news. Everything was removed because money, fame, like material possession, and no God at all. But when you put God, you will become happier. If God is here, he will definitely supply the next part here. God will supply the remaining four. God will supply your needs. God will supply your finances. God will supply your needs in your career, in your workplaces, your family, when you make God your priority. Again, for me, this is really very important. Like, I even share with other people that I can lose everything. I can lose my money. I can lose what I'm doing, my business. But my faith is my anchor. My faith is my anchor. It's okay for me to lose everything. As long as I have God, I know that I can get that back. I know that God will make a way to give me everything I need to sustain my needs, to bless me with what I want, to make me happier as long as I have him. I already experienced living a life without God for 4 months in year 2012. And I don't want to experience that ever again. The darkest moment in my life happened for 4 months in my 31 years of existence in year 2012 when I abandoned God, when I declared that he is not real, when I did not pray, when I did not go to church. That's the darkest moment in my life. I don't know how to explain the emptiness I had in my heart. I was even suicidal. I want to end my life. But right this moment, okay, my life is not perfect. Mind you, I still have problems. I still have a lot of struggles. And every day, sometimes big problems, and then small problem, but it's part of who I am now. But the good thing is, even whatever problems will come my way, I am confident, I am happy, because I know that God is with me. And now, the blessings that I have now is something that really, you know, blown me away. I had my company, it's flourishing. You know, every day I receive people connecting with me. I no longer market even my Write Your Legacy book writing workshop. People are coming to me. God is bringing them to me. And you know what's my biggest blessing in my Write Your Legacy? God is bringing me godly people. One thing that I'm really grateful, and that's my prayer. Lord God, bring to me authors who are kind. Bring to me authors who are humble. Bring to me authors who have personal relationship with you. Or if you can bring me authors who don't have personal relationship with you, bring them to me, but allow me, Lord God, make me an instrument so that they will know you more. And there are some who attended the workshop who are not highly religious, but when they attended my workshop, they became, you know, engaged with the Lord. They met God, they experienced God because they attended my workshop. I love this. This is so amazing. Now, in everything I do, I put God first. In everything you do, you need to put God first. When I started this business, a lot of prayers were recited. When I'm planning to go home, I'm telling you, 4 times fasting, 21 days fasting to ask for God's blessing before I reside in Oman. I'm not yet that contented. So I had another 21 days prayer and fasting. And then another 21 days prayer and fasting. Daniel's fast. And the last part, last September, August, September 2019, 40 days prayer and fasting. I did that, Daniel's fast, with one prayer. Lord, sanctify my decision of going home in the Philippines. That's my main prayer. And if I will receive the blessing, build me, Lord God, create foundation in me that I can carry it, that it will not crush me, that it will not destroy me. I don't want my blessings to become curse. I want it to keep as blessings so that I can help other people. And God answered my prayer. Okay, 5 things for tonight. So that your blessings will not become curse. Number one that you need to do is your first foundation, or your first foundation is your character. Also, your integrity. It's very crucial. I promote that integrity, integrity, integrity. Before you do something that you think can destroy your integrity, think 1,000,000 times. Escape that moment. And then if you want to kill someone, please run away, count the ant, or go to the church, call someone before you do anything bad. If you ruin your integrity, oh my gosh, it's difficult to get back. So protect that. Also, humility. This is very crucial. So that the blessings will pass through, the blessing will not stop. You need to embrace humility. That's our number one. Number two is all about your relationship. Be kind to people. Be kind to people. Parang 10,000 pa lang, 15, you are still earning 10,000 or 50,000, but you already speak and walk and talk like a king, like someone who is on top. Don't do that. Be kind to other people, especially on your way up. And when you reach the top, remain as you are. Remain, like, nurture your relationship with your friends and your family. That's number two. Number three is never ever stop learning. Now, personal development is very crucial. Don't stop reading books. Don't stop attending seminars. Because if you will stop, that's the start of your downfall. Number four, always remember that our top priority is God. Money, material possession, accolades, awards, secondary. It's not bad to aim for more money. It's not bad to have to win or to receive awards. But know that these are secondary. While you are doing that, never ever forget that your top priority is God. That's number five, your spiritual relationship, your spiritual maturity. 5 things so that your blessings will not become a curse. Can I request everyone to close your eyes? I want you to have that encounter with the Lord. Lord God, send the Holy Spirit, touch the hearts of these people. Experience God right this very moment. Be delighted because God is in front of you. He is smiling in front of you, and He is happy that you are experiencing Him, encountering Him today. God is not a feeling, He's a person, and He's in front of you. Our dear and ever-loving God, in our brokenness, yes, Lord, we still commit sins. We have weaknesses. We have problems. We have struggles. But Lord God, we are here in front of you, being so much open and bold with who we are. And thank you, Lord God, that you acknowledge us. You acknowledge our presence, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for your compassion. We believe that you're the King of Kings. We believe that you're the Lord of Lords. We believe that you're the Most High God. Your name is powerful, the name above all names. And we honor you tonight. We just want to exalt your name higher and higher. Gusto ka namin papurihan, Panginoon. Lord God, we thank you for your big message tonight. That before we receive our blessings, while our blessings are underway, we should protect our character. We should develop our foundation so that our blessings will not become curse. That we should embrace humility, our character, integrity. That we should not stop growing and learning. That we should nurture our relationship with our loved ones. That we should always think that money, material possessions are just secondary. And that our top priority is you. Lord God, teach our hearts to prioritize you. Teach our hearts to seek you every minute, every second of our lives. Lord, I lift to you every person watching right this very moment. You know the desires of their hearts. You know their struggles. You know their problems. And Lord God, I lift them to you. Take over, Lord God, especially to those, to the burdens that they can no longer carry. Take over, Lord. Take over, Lord God. We want you to fight the battles for us. Thank you, Jesus. Lord God, anyone right now who is experiencing her or his darkest moment, anyone who is depressed, suicidal, we pray, Lord God, for a rescue right this very moment. In Jesus' name, they will encounter you. They will experience you. And Lord God, teach their hearts as just a phase in their lives that if they will not give up, if they will hold on to their faith, they will experience breakthroughs upon breakthroughs. Lord, I also lift to you the families of these people. You know how much they love their families, their parents, their spouse, their siblings, their children. May you be the center of their relationship. Lord, any family right now experiencing some problem, conflict, I pray for peace. I pray for understanding in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God, for the gifts of reconciliation. May you be the center of their relationship. May you be the center of their families. Lord, bless each and every member of your family. Lord God, I also lift to you the health of these people. Anyone right now experiencing sickness physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually, heal them, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. We believe that you're the greatest healer and you're the ultimate doctor. Thank you, Lord God, that you're healing now the cells, the bones, the organs of these people, especially those who are sick. You are clearing their blood vessels in Jesus' name. Lord God, you are clearing, you are healing their emotions. You are removing the anger in their hearts. You are removing the guilt in their hearts. You are removing the anxiety. You are removing the doubts in their hearts. In Jesus' name, you are making their hearts pure. Lord God, I lift to you those who are experiencing mental health problems. Yes, Lord God, you are normalizing their thoughts now. You are balancing the chemicals in their brains in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God. Lord, I also lift to you those who are experiencing a spiritual dryness. I pray that you rekindle the fire in their hearts for them to know that the ultimate happiness is all about having you, that you never abandon us, that we're the ones who run away from you. Thank you, Lord God, that the fire, the faith is now fanning in their hearts. Thank you, Lord God, for rekindling their faith. In Jesus' name, they are healed with their spiritual dryness. In Jesus' name. Lord God, I also lift to you the finances of these people. You know, Lord God, there are problems about money, about bills to pay, problem with the hospitalization, any problems related to money with the food that they eat. Lord God, we believe that you're a God of prosperity, and we will not stop confessing, Lord, that you're a God of abundance, that as long as we have you, the God that we worship is rich, and so we will never experience his scarcity. Thank you, Lord God. We're opening our lives to receive all the blessings that you want to give us. give us, especially financial blessings in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God, that you are doing miracles, especially to those who are suffocated with their finances. Thank you, Lord God, that you are providing now in Jesus' name. Lord, I also lift to you the bread and butter of these people, their workplaces. May you use them, Lord God, so that they can inspire their colleagues. They will become your ambassador. They will become your representative to share the good news, to bless their co-workers, that they will become the reason of harmony, that they will become the reason of abundant relationship and not the cause of fight, not the cause of conflict, Lord God, but they will become a reason of innovation, of excellence and happiness in their workplaces in Jesus' name. Lord, I lift to you the dreams of these people will never stop raising their dreams, whatever dreams inside their hearts, maybe to work overseas, maybe to go back home in the Philippines, maybe to start a business, maybe to complete a degree, maybe to start a degree, maybe to be promoted, maybe to have a family, maybe to have a child. Maybe to write a book, whatever dreams inside their hearts, Lord God, we lift them up to you. And we believe that in your perfect moment, their dreams will come true. Lord, the very reason why we're gathering in the past 220 days is to pray for this pandemic. Yes, Lord, we're excited to hear that this world, this earth is already COVID-free in Jesus' name. That we will come out with a stronger faith because of this pandemic. Lord God, we will not be shaken. We believe that you're already fixing everything. Thank you, Lord God, for healing our world. And lastly, Lord, we just want to storm the heaven with praises and thanksgiving. First and foremost, we thank you for the gifts of life. We celebrate another 24 hours in our lives. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us this opportunity to become a blessing, to inspire people to do good things, to worship you. And we pray that you give us more years so that we can serve our purpose, so that we can bless many people. Lord God, I thank you for this spiritual squad that we have now. We also thank you, Lord God, for their lives, for what they are doing. I lift to you, Lord God, all their prayers, Lord God, all their thanksgiving prayers. I lift them up to you. And Lord God, we thank you for the material gifts that you have given us, the food that we eat, the money that we have, the comfortable home where we stay, all these things came from you. And so tonight, we just want to bring back all the glory, all the honor, all the praises to the most powerful name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Purihin ang Panginoon. Ayun, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. Magpapawisan ako. Sobrang init. I want to say hi to Eileen Aguirre. A blessed evening po, Coach. Thank you so much. Larry Fernando is also watching. Thank you, my dear. Bless. God bless you. Maricel Arizabal is also watching. Blessed evening to everyone. Doc Marilyn Passion, good evening po sa lahat. Hi, Coach. Blessed evening po. Maraming salamat, Doc. Pakisama lang sana si Signal. Okay? Alam mo yung Signal na yan. Hindi yan parang yung nang iwan sa akin. Nako, babalik yan. Ina din ang signal ko, Doc. Same tayo. Big message. Good evening, Coach. Sabi ni Cindy Gail Maliari. Maraming salamat. Eileen, a blessed Friday evening po. Friday na ba? Nawawala na. Out of trail na ako. Sabi ni Maricel, I just read a feed of chats. Can't view the video. Anyway. Okay, maganda to. The best of all foundation, it must be the core of all the foundation. Ang spiritual foundation daw natin, dapat ito ang pinaka-core. This is the most important according to Maricel Arizabal Guillen. Also, sabi ni Doc Marilyn, ang ganda ng message, the foundation of all good character is knowing God. And knowing God leads to a good relationship to others. Napaka-importante niyan, Doc. Yes, Doc, best relations is only with God alone. You can do all things if you are with God. Sabi pa ni Doc, the higher we are placed, the more humble we should walk and talk. Ayun. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Maraming salamat sa pagsama. Pasensya na napahaba ang kwentuhan natin sa gabing ito. But I wanna say thank you for the love, for the trust, and for the support. I'm forever grateful. And let's nourish our spirit and join hands in prayer that this pandemic will soon end. Purihin ang Panginoon. I love you all. Bye-bye. Thank you.